Hey everyone, how are you? This is creativeitresources.com and this is tutorial number 3. I'm Jeff and I wanted to speak specifically about GoDaddy's Business Managed WordPress Hosting Package, and I'm interested in 3 specific things. How easy is it to manage the WordPress site, backup and recovery, which is very important, and do you have access to your files? To have access to the show notes, go to creativeitresources.com/tutorial003. There I have links, additional information, and resources, all that will be available to you. So let me turn around, we'll get started, and I'll give you a tour. This should look familiar. This is GoDaddy's main page. Let's check out the WordPress sites and blogs. Scroll down to the packages, and we talked about the starter package in tutorial 2. We're going to talk about the business package this round. We're mostly interested in the 5 websites, so let's take a look. Here in my account, first let's check out the email. And email is not included with the managed WordPress. So fortunately, we have 2 items that we've bought, which is the domain and the hosting package. So GoDaddy provides free email forwarding. And essentially all that is you create up a email address with your domain name. It forwards the emails to your primary account, for example, Gmail, Yahoo, or your ISP. Let's look at the managed WordPress. And let's ignore the starter managed WordPress. We've talked about that again. We're going to focus on the business. It's a new account, so we're literally starting from scratch. The option button here provides the ability to upgrade the account, which we're not interested in. Let's click launch. And here we can migrate an existing site. All you do is you provide the URL, your admin passwords, and it can actually copy it over to a temporary domain name. We'll cover that in a later tutorial as well. But let's focus on creating a new site. I'm going to go ahead and use citrdemo.com. You could use your domain name. Add our user, admin username. Again, don't use admin. That actually shows it in the checkbox right over here to the right. Usually I just like to preface that with an acronym or something for the domain. Okay, cool. The install is finished. I just kind of buzzed that really quick. And let's go to, I believe the URL is gateway. There we go. So let me tell you where we're at. Let me back out to my account. And if we go to manage WordPress and we click launch, there you go. This one here is the starter demo site. We can completely ignore that. This is one of our business installs, we'll just call it. Notice that we have the citrdemo.com. So we can install 5 sites, and we'll cover that in just a moment. The way that we would do that is by clicking set up here, and this will eventually go away when we have our 5 sites installed. But let's go into settings and check out what we have for controlling this. Here we manage our domains, and we'll come back to that in just a moment. We're going to look at the backups, the FTP settings, and staging. This is new compared to the starter package, which is really cool. I really like this feature. And the last one is remove this site. I'm going to add CITR demo 2. When we add domains, all these are aliases, or they point to the primary domain's content, or basically to the site's content. Add another one that's a subdomain. All these different domains, and they point to the same content. So actually, let's open up a new tab, citrdemo.com. Here's our new site. Let's do citrdemo2.com. There you go. See, it's the same content. Let's preface this with test, citrdemo.com. There you go. Same content, just basically we have the alias URL. Let's go back to the settings here. Backups are created daily, and you have 30 days with the backups. And the unfortunate part is, and this doesn't show it, maybe we can go over to the starter package. We'll look at it. But the idea is that you have a backup every 30 days and it's managed by GoDaddy. You cannot force a backup, but you can restore to any particular point in time for those backups. Here in the FTP settings, it gives you all your connection information here, your username, your password, your URL, your port number. Database can use PHP MyAdmin. You can go in there and you can export your tables, whatnot, which is all fine. And the staging, this one is really cool. So let's clone our production environment. All right, let's go back in here to settings. We'll check out the staging site. And it's in progress. Okay, so it'll take a couple minutes. We'll come back to that. Let's go over here to the starter package. I'll show you what the backups look like. I believe I have quite a few backups here. We can restore files, database, or both. Here we go. Got 8 days worth. I can restore any particular point in time for these backups. But as you can see, there's no way to force a backup. So we're doing for our staging here. Still going. We'll come back to that. I'm going to install a couple more sites, and that way we can look at those, and then we'll look at the staging sites as well. What I've done is I've installed the other remaining 4 sites. So we have a total of 5 sites. Ignore this starter package. The starter, you can only do 1, and the business, we're able to do 5. So there you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We wanted to check out the staging. Here's the staging site for our CRTRdemo.com. And basically, you can deploy from staging to production, copies everything. Or you can copy production to staging. Last thing is we can remove either the main site, which includes staging, or we can remove the staging site. I wanted to point out one last thing before we jump away. Oh, and the URL for the staging is click manage. You can go to your production site or you can go to your staging site. Here's the URL. And that also gives you the FTP settings back here as well, so you can connect to it. But I wanted to point out something. I've got FileZilla open. This is really important to know because some people like to remove and overwrite or whatever all the files. The only files that you can overwrite here is WP content. You notice that the owner is CITR237, etc. This is the username, the FTP username for HD access, for, let's see here, robots.txt and the WP config. The WP includes, you can't access that. You cannot overwrite those files. They are read only. Just so you're aware of, the only way to really modify this content is to remove the site or use staging, override it, whatever, but you can't override it manually through any FTP or anything like that.
As you can tell, there's not a lot of differences between the starter and the business managed WordPress. The primary difference is with the staging and the additional sites. The staging is great for isolating your production environment. You can use it for test and development. The other sites, you don't necessarily have to host another site. You can use one to create a site where you can explore other themes, plugins, things of that nature, and you're still isolating everything to your production environment. The business managed WordPress, in my opinion, is perfect for someone who wants to just host manage WordPress or a WordPress site. The economy and the deluxe, they get a little bit more advanced and you can explore different technologies. I know it doesn't come with email, but with GoDaddy, you can check out their email services. Also, another option is to go to office365.com. They got a lot there other than just hosting email as well, so I highly recommend that. Don't forget, go to creativeitresources.com/tutorial003. There you can check out the show notes, additional information. You can leave comments as well. So again, thanks again, guys. I appreciate you stopping by. You're awesome. We'll talk to you soon. Thanks again.